Hello there. In this video, we're going to continue our quest baseline data ML and AI in order to get this badge for our resume, for our LinkedIn profile. And we will go with the second lab, data prep quick start. So let's click on it. As you can see, we're going to get charged one credit. It's introductory. Introductory means that we will learn how to move around on Google Cloud platform and work with Dataprep. So Dataprep is an intelligent data service for visual exploring, cleaning, and preparing data for analysis. It is serverless, it works at any scale, and there is no infrastructure to deploy or manage. It's easy data preparation with clicks and no code. This is the main point, with clicks and no code, and you're going to see it next. So just to remind you, if you are ready, press the start lab. Otherwise, don't press it. Just go and make your coffee or go to the toilet or do something else. And when you are sure for yourself that you are ready, start the countdown. Otherwise, don't do it because there's no pause on the time. So for me, I'm ready. I will start my lab. I'm not a robot. I'm using a subscription. You can get credits, free credits, if you attend the Cloud Study Jam from GDGs. I'm from GDG Cloud Saloniki. There are other GDG maybe in your town or near you. You can check it. And also, if you follow Qwik Labs on the social media, they have free browser codes to play around on Qwik Labs. So these are the credentials that are created for me. My username as a student, my password, and the project ID of my project that I'm going to work on Google Cloud platform. I'm copying the username. I'm already working in incognito mode. It's best, the best way to work is on incognito mode. You can right click and then go on private window on incognito mode. I'm already there. That's why I'm clicking here. This is from a previous video, so I'm changing my account, getting the password. I accept the terms. This is for real projects. For me, it doesn't matter, just confirm. And I'm redirected to Google Cloud Platform. I have to do one last check over here, the terms. If you are starting your way for your project and you want to get periodic emails, you have to check it, otherwise agree and continue. Before starting, let's check. Yes, I'm on as a student here, not on my email and my real project or my company's project. And this one, project ID, is exactly the same as this one. Over here, we have the navigation menu, the compute power, engines, the storage, the databases that we can use for networking, for operation. It used to be named Stack Driver, now it's named Operation. We have also tools over here for Cloud Bid, Tasks, Container Registry, everything. Big data over here. We're going to go work with data prep and artificial intelligence. So let's go back. We have already finished with these steps. And first thing first, we have to check if we have the credentials, the correct permissions with the identity and access management, the IAM roles. So let's go over here. Let's scroll up. IAM and admin and to IAM over here, and it says to check if we have the editor role. As you can see, we do have the editor role over here. If someone doesn't have it, you have to go to add. navigation, home, IAM admin, add. And for new member, you have to put your project number and then compute like this one. Okay, this is the project number I have. You will have yours, you can find it right after it. From then you will have to select a role, go to the project and then to editor, and then just click save. I have it so I don't need this, that's why I'm canceling it. Now we want to create a cloud storage bucket in our project. So we go to the navigation menu, click down on the storage, and we need to create a bucket, but I don't, first let's close it, create a bucket. And we must give a unique name. So when we say unique name, let's say google.com is different from google.us, it's different from google1.com, okay, it's a unique. On my student accounts, what I do is I grab my project ID because it is unique. It is created only for me, only for this lab, and paste it over here. We don't want to go all the steps right now. Just click create. And it's ready. We have created our bucket and we need to remember the bucket name for our later steps. That's why I always grab my project ID. It's easy again to copy it from here. Let's check my progress. I get a green tick and over here I get 50 out of 100 because I have only two steps in order to finish successfully this lab. Now we are going to initialize the cloud data prep. It says that we have to go to data prep, accept everything, agree, allow, username. Okay, let's go and see what's going on. We have to scroll down to find data prep. It's on the big data. Click data prep. I have read it, accept. Again, agree and continue. Allow, allow Trifactor to access project data, yes. Again, if you can see, I have my student account. This is my account, click on it, allow. It's all Greek to you, I know. I'm checking and I'm accepting. Continue, I don't want to change this. Okay, let's rearrange that. We have done everything. Continue and click on hide tool over here. Great. So we have to check the progress. And if you want now, you can go over here, click on Add Lab, and you are going to get a green tick, and this lab is going to be successfully finished from you, but everything starts from here below. Okay, so it's up to you. Do you want to get a badge or do you want to understand how data prep works? For those that want to continue, let's go over here and we want to create a flow. And we have to name it Fake 2016. which is the Federal Elections Commission from 2016. And as a description, let's copy it from here and paste it here, and then click Create. Next, got it. Great. Now we are going to import our dataset. So click on Import and Add Datasets. And over here, in the left menu, select Google Cloud Storage. And over here to edit the path, and we can copy this paste it here and then go and cancel buttons go click on the US spec the plus icon okay we're here we want the this one we want to add it and we will rename it Candidate Master 2016. Great. We want also the IT cont 2016 text. Let's go IT cont. Let's check it again. This one, and we also need to rename it campaign contributions. So we have exactly the same over here. We are ready to import and add to the flow. We have imported everything here. Let's go back. So we start with the Candidate Master 2016. We go to add and then to recipe over here, add. And edit. I don't want to see the helpers. As you can easily understand, whatever is green is fine. Whatever is red, we have missing values. We have also missing values over here, but these are criticals. And let's go back to see what's going on. As you can see, the transformer page is where you build your transformation recipe and see the results applied to the sample. When you are satisfied with what you see, execute the job against your dataset. Each of the column heads have a name and a value that specify the data type. So on column, let's go on column 6 over here and click on that. We have strings, integers, decimal, boolean, daytime, and more types over here. Also, when you click on the flag, you can see details on the right. These are the details. You can see the valid, mismatched, and missing. Let's click X on the top right of the details to close it. Okay. In the following steps, we will explore data in the grid view and apply transformation steps to our receipt. So we will go on column 5, which we are having data from 1919 till 2064, back to the future. And we will widen our column 5, and we want to make it wider. We are here, okay, and click on 2016, this one, the tallest. In the suggestions, keep rows selection and click add to add this step to your receipt. Okay, so over here, let me check something first. On the right, it says from 2016 till 2018, but we have until 2017. It doesn't matter, let's add. Okay, in column 6, over the and click in the mismatch right portion of the header selection to the mismatch rows. So let me go a little bit on the right. Click on them. And scroll down to find the mismatch values and notice how most of these records have the value P in column 7 and US in column 6. The mismatch occurs because column 6 is marked as a state column indicated by the flag icon, but there are no states such as US values. Okay, so United States is not a state. If you scroll down, it's not that, so click the X over here and then click on the flag icon on column 6 and change it to string column. So let's go over here, click this one and make it a string. As you can see, we don't have mismatch values anymore. Now we will filter on just the presidential candidates, who are those records that have the value P in column 7. In the histogram for column 7, over the two bins to see which is H and which is P. Then click on the P. This one is H. We can see over here we have two categories. The tallest one is H and the smallest one is P. Click on it. And then click Add. So where column P equals as you can see, now we have only 2016 and only P presidents. Now we are going to join a page and we can add our current dataset to another dataset or recipe based on information that is common to both datasets. Before joining the contribution file to the candidates file, clean up the contribution file. So we have to click on FEC 2016, the dataset selector in the top of the grid view page. Click to select the grayed out campaign contributions. In the right pane, click Add Recipe. Edit click here and then add new step. Now we're going to remove extra delimiters in the dataset, so you can always try to write it by yourself or just copy it from here and go over here and then we have these results. Click the add button . Great. Add another step and then write join and search the join datasets. So let's go over here again. New step. Join datasets. Click on the candidate master 2016 second. This one. And accept. We have to wait a little while. Okay, everything is here. Now we have to hover or in the join key section and click on the pencil over here. This one, okay. It has nothing, but if you go over here and click on the pencil, you get this one. And then we have to add in the key panel, the suggestion join keys is column 2 equals to column 11. Here it says column 17 to column 11, but we want column 2 to column 11. It has changed over here. And then save and continue. We have it over here. Great. Then click next and then the checkbox of the columns to add all columns. Click next. Over here, add all columns. Review. And then add. Now we are joining both of them. Great. Let's continue. For summary of data, generate a useful summary by aggregating, averaging, and counting the contribution in column 16 and grouping the candidates' IDs, names, and party affiliation in columns 2, 24, and 8, respectively. At the top of the receipt panel on the left, click on New Step and enter the following formula in the transformation. So let's copy it first. Let's go back. We need New Step, Search Transformation, our code, whatever we said over here, it is written here. We want to sum the column 16, average column 16. Count if column 16 is above 0, group. And then click add. As you can see, we have the categories on column 2. We have addresses, state, the money. Let's go back. Now we'll rename the columns so it is easier to understand what's going on. Let's copy this code. Let's go back. New step. As you can see, we have renamed it. Add it. It's easier for us now to understand. And a new step to round the average contribution amount. So again, a new step. Average contribution amount. And end it. Great, let's go back. And you have finished. Let's close it so you can see what we have done. We took something, data sets, and we cleaned the first one, then we combined with the second one, and we got this result, the candidate ID for the presidential elections, the name, the party that the candidate is affiliated, the total contribution sum, the average, and the number of contribution. As you can see, it's a lot of money, and without coding any line, it's so easy. This time we have worked with Dataprep, so you have to type cloud.google.com/dataprep and scroll down to read what it is and what it can do, the documentation and everything else over here. Okay. Also the pricing. Next steps. After finishing each lab, it's a good tip always to go and read the documentation of the tool of the technology you have already used on Qwik Labs. If you want to learn how to use Google Cloud Platform, how to work with Google Cloud Platform, how to prepare yourself for the Google Cloud certification, it's a good tip always after the lab to go and read the documentation. It will help you a lot, believe me. So, thank you for watching this video. See you on the next one.